Right now is a great opportunity to sell on eBay. Number one, if you're really struggling financially, start selling stuff around your house. Look around. Maybe you got a computer monitor, or maybe you have a camera case, or maybe you have a desk, or maybe a unique lamp that your grandmother gave you. Maybe it's rare if you're willing to sell it. A printer, all different types of items. You could lot up baseball cards and, you know, if you have old Pokemon cards, these things have taken off in price. Start by selling some stuff around your house on eBay. What's going on, everybody? Steve here, Rake and Profit over at rakeandprofit.com. And I was just going through one of my comments on YouTube, and someone was thanking me for the content that I create, saying I'm in between jobs, I'm waiting for the stimulus check, and I'm really struggling, essentially. I'm paraphrasing, and I appreciate your content. And this I'm not sharing this to pat myself on the back, although it does feel good, but I want to make this video really for anyone out there who's struggling. And maybe you lost your job and you don't have a lot of money. Maybe you only have a couple hundred dollars left in your bank account and you're really struggling. You're waiting for the stimulus check and you're doing little odd jobs on the side, but it's really not enough. You want to make more money. I want to talk to you guys about a way that I've been making money for over 6 years. And this isn't some crazy multi-level marketing scheme. This isn't some build an agency and spend $6,000 or put your $20 into an altcoin and when Bitcoin hits 600,000, you're gonna be rich, right? Although I am a firm believer in cryptocurrency. I'm not telling you to do this in this video. But all jokes aside, selling on eBay, right? I know it's not the sexiest thing in the world, but right now is a great opportunity to sell on eBay. Number one, if you're really struggling financially, start selling stuff around your house. Look around. Maybe you got a computer monitor, or maybe you have a camera case, or maybe you have a desk, or maybe a unique lamp that your grandmother gave you. Maybe it's rare if you're willing to sell it. A printer, all different types of items. You could lot up baseball cards and, if you have old Pokemon cards, these things have taken off in price. Start by selling some stuff around your house on eBay. Now, eBay is great because, unlike selling on Amazon, there's really no upfront costs. When you sell on Amazon, there isn't a ton of upfront costs, but if you want like a good plan, it's $40 a month, and then there's storage fees, and then, you gotta ship things out to the warehouse. And I like Amazon more than eBay, but for the beginner who has no reselling experience, I wouldn't worry about that now. You could step there eventually, but I would start with eBay. eBay is great because you could start by selling stuff around your house. It's fun. You could download the eBay app, put it on your phone, start taking pictures, and it's super simple. Literally, when you find an item that you want to sell on eBay, you just look it up on your phone and you hit the button sell like item and list it. Take a couple pictures, put it up. You could sell it as an auction or buy it now. And there's a lot of opportunities just selling around your house, but also thrift stores, garage sales, going on Facebook Marketplace, Craigslist, Nextdoor app. You can find free items on Facebook Marketplace. You can create ads and say, hey, I'm struggling right now. For anybody who has some junk, I'll come pick it up at your house and you don't have to worry about it. But unfortunately, I don't have a lot of money. You'll have people that are willing to help you, but you have to ask. Start telling your friends and family. Tell the guy at the coffee shop. Tell, the girl at the grocery store when you're talking. Obviously, bring it up casually. Don't just be pitching people. Say, hey, I'm a reseller. I'm a treasure hunter. I buy and sell stuff online, and fake it till you make it. You would be shocked at how many stupid items. Really just items that are just pointless in a sense sell for a lot of money. Certain board games sell extremely well. The whole Pokemon craze, that's something that's trending right now. Broken electronics, old Sony CD players, vintage clothing, vintage toys, books, all different types of items. Those romance novels, the ones that everyone just throws away. Did you know if you lot them up in lots of 40 or 50, you could sell them for about $1 a piece? Now, it doesn't seem like much, but people are just giving these things away. You ship it media mail for $4, you sell it for 50, you make, 39, 40 bucks after fees, maybe a little less than that, $36. That's just an example. If you're struggling right now, look into selling on eBay. Go on YouTube, you can check out my channel. There's plenty of other channels out there that are great. And just start flipping items on eBay. There's a huge community. For the folks who are, you know, following me and subscribe to me now, you probably already turned this video off because you're like, Steve, I know about this opportunity. I've been doing it for the last 6 years. I've been following you all 2000 videos. But even then, for some people who are maybe sitting on the sideline feeling bad about themselves, like, get back up. There's so many opportunities out there, and there's so many different items that you could sell on this platform. eBay is like the wild, wild west. When you sell on Amazon, there's rules and restrictions, and you know, certain brands like Disney, you can't sell because you have to get a wholesale invoice. It's a whole different game. I wouldn't worry about Amazon, but if you're sitting back waiting for your stimulus check, or you're trying to find a job and you're struggling, start selling stuff around your house, start getting free items on Craigslist, Facebook Marketplace, Nextdoor app. You can create wanted ads, or you can just search through the free items list, start reaching out to people, spread the word around town that, hey, I'm starting an eBay business. If you have some stuff, I'll sell it for you and I'll give you a 25% cut or a 50-50 cut. Consignment gets a little more complicated, so I would probably just try to get it for free, or maybe just say, I'll give you a little cut, I'll take you out for a coffee or something. And you know, if you're open and vulnerable about your situation, people, they'll give you stuff and they won't even think twice, because most people, they'll give you $400 worth of items that they think is just junk. People aren't gonna give you the iPhones, they're not gonna give you the, you know, the super expensive electronics. Some will, but most people are gonna just give you random items like clothes and books and just outdated stuff that they don't think is valuable, but on eBay it is, because they don't make it anymore. And people, they wanna relive their childhood, or they want that concert t-shirt from the 90s, right? Or from the 80s that they can't find anywhere and they wanna relive that time. Man, there's concert t-shirts that sell for over 500 bucks. Matter of fact, I was at the Manchester Savers. This was probably 3 or 4 months ago, and I was out there scanning books with my mom, and my mom, she retired at 64. She's now 66. She's been selling books for 6 years. We were out scanning books, and this guy came up with his two kids and was like, hey, I follow you on YouTube, what's going on? We started having a conversation. He told me, you know, I was in Connecticut at the time. He told me that he went to the Berlin Turnpike Savers and found a bunch of Harley Davidson vintage t-shirts. And one of them he sold for over $500. It's the one with the pig on it. I don't remember exactly which one it was. But I mean, I was just shocked. But I wasn't really that shocked, because as crazy as it sounds, like, people do this stuff all the time, not with t-shirts, but with all different types of items. You know, there's a guy that used to be on YouTube, Golden Finger Picker. He sold a record, I think, for thousands of dollars that he found at a garage sale for, I don't know, a couple bucks or something. These things aren't gonna happen every single day, but if you go out and you go to thrift stores and stuff, there's opportunities. Now, there's other resellers there, but there's opportunities. So you just go pick it up, free items or even dirt cheap items at thrift stores, garage sales, bring it home, look it up on eBay. There's tons of videos that'll teach you how to do it. And you don't have to sit around waiting for someone else to help you or save you. You can go out there, now that you know about this, and take life and you know, make it your you know what. So go out there and make it happen. It's not gonna be easy. It's gonna take a little bit of time. There's gonna be a learning curve. I know a lot of people who, I hate to say it, but a lot of people that are outside of their 20s, in their 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s, stop learning ever since they left school, and that's a big mistake. You wanna always continue to learn. You always wanna continue to educate yourself. And you know, that's a muscle that you have to build over time. So if you haven't been learning anything new for a while, it's gonna be a pain in the butt. It's gonna suck at first. But learn how to sell on eBay. That's a skill that can pay you forever. I'm not saying you're gonna get rich doing it, but I know, regardless of what happened, right? If my businesses got shut down, if this went bad, if that went bad, if I ended up losing everything, I know that I would have a skill to be able to make money selling on eBay, selling on Amazon. And there's thousands of items that I can source from all over the place. Literally, I just tickled the surface by giving you a couple ideas of how to get started selling, by selling stuff around your house, on Craigslist, Facebook Marketplace. I didn't even touch library sales or liquidators or online arbitrage or retail arbitrage, or going to Walmarts and Targets and the clearance sections and estate sales and, you know, local auctions. I haven't even tickled the surface, okay? But hopefully I inspired you to start looking into this, because there's too many people struggling now, and it's BS. It's complete BS. There's ways to get around it, and you don't have to wait for people to help you. I know some of us, we need it, but hopefully you listen to this video and go out there. And for anyone who's watching now who is making money and who is what you would call successful as a reseller, drop some encouraging words down below in the comments, and hopefully that changes some people's lives. So with that being said, if you enjoyed this video, hit that like button, leave a comment, a question, and I would love to be able to help you out in the comments. Talk soon. Bye.